Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see in a short time all the basic features you need to know to start with Pinnacle Studio 21. Leave us suggestions in the video description to improve our next video guides for this software. Pinnacle Studio is a professional video editing software used to realize film-like videos, slideshows, and even DVD menus, applying amazing visual effects, transitions, and editing. In this video, we are going to check only the basic features, but do not forget to open our full guide in the video description to check out the other amazing features of this software. When opening Pinnacle, the welcome page opens, showing all the new updates on Pinnacle Studio and several useful tutorials and extras. At the very top, you have several buttons. The Home button opens the Welcome page. The others, from Import to Export, the different workspaces you use to create your own video. The Import workspace is used to import all the media files you have to work with, such as videos, photos, and sound. Edit is the main workspace used to create and edit your own project, starting from the imported media. Export is used to render your project in order to export it and upload it outside. Let's see how these different sections are used to create your own video. To start with a new Pinnacle project, go to File, New, then to Movie. At this point, switch to the Import workspace to import your media files to start working. On top, you have several tabs, each representing a different source. For example, you can use Capture Video, Stop Motion, and Snapshot to record videos, frames, or snapshots from your webcam, and DVD Blu-ray to import media from any disc. You can use the left panel to fix several settings, such as where to save your media or set any file format. To import media from your computer, you can use either My Computer or Scan for Assets. With My Computer, you can browse and select for your media files directly. Scan for Assets is used to search and import media files, even by kind or format. When using My Computer, browse for your media files and select them by clicking on their small square. You can also select or deselect all media by using Check All and Uncheck All at the bottom. On the left, you can fix several import settings, such as the import mode. If you use Link, all media files will be just linked to your Pinnacle project. If you use Copy, you will copy the media files inside the Pinnacle folders. When you are ready, use Start Import to import all your media selected. These are all collected inside a project bin, which is a folder used to group all media used in a particular project. On the left panel, under Import To, you can select the project bin to import your media. If you select none, a new project bin is created with the actual date as a name. Once files are imported, you can switch to the Edit workspace to start creating your own video. This is divided in two main parts. On top, you have several panels such as the Library that collects files, templates, effects, and transitions, the Editor used to apply corrections on files, and the Video Preview on the extreme right. At the bottom, you have the Project Timeline, which is where you edit your video project. To add files on your timeline, you can drag and drop these from the several sections of the library panel, such as Project Bins in red, to browse from collections of imported files, Library Media in blue to get all media from folders linked to Pinnacle, Projects in violet to import entire Pinnacle projects directly. All files imported on the timeline are called Assets or Clips, showing their file name and a background color depending on their kind: blue for photos, light blue for videos, yellow for sound files, and green for titles. On each of these assets, a quick preview is shown, such as thumbnails on pictures and video frames, and sound waveforms on both audio files and video recordings. All clips are contained and ordered inside rows called audio-visual tracks. You can better check your timeline content either by zooming in and out with your mouse wheel while holding Control down, or by extending the track height by clicking and dragging their edges. The video preview is used to check your media content with its source mode and its timeline mode. When you select any file from the library, the preview works in source mode, playing the content of such file on its own, showing frames or audio waveforms. Whereas when working on the timeline, the video preview plays in timeline mode, showing the timeline content with all of its clips inside, in particular what is under the red marker you see. For example, you can check a particular instant of time by clicking on top of the timeline. Or preview the project frame by frame with no audio by clicking and dragging on the left or right, or by scrolling your mouse wheel. To playback frames and sound, you have to use the player below the preview, or use the spacebar key to play and stop quickly. You can also play back in full screen mode with the first button on top. Let's see how to edit your clips inside the timeline. To move a clip through time, just click and drag it through the same track or in another one. Just pay attention when clips overlap in time. If you overlap a clip on another one on the same track, this one will be cut. If visual clips get overlapped on different tracks, they are managed depending on the track's order. All clips staying on a higher track in position are always shown above all other clips that stay on lower tracks. When you move or edit clips, you may have to wait for the progress bar above. This simply improves the preview quality on your project. To cut, copy, paste, or delete a clip, just right-click on it. You can make fast copies of a clip by moving it while holding Control down. In case you make any mistake, use Control and Z to undo. Use the Undo and the Redo buttons in the top left corner to manage your past actions made in order to undo or redo them in order. To split a clip, click on the clip to select it, place the red marker on the exact position, and then use Split Clips. To stretch or shorten a clip in time, approach its edges and click and drag. You can do this freely on pictures, but not in case of videos and sound files that have a limited length. When you shorten these, you simply cut part of their content. And when you stretch them over, blank red parts will be added, such as the last video frame for videos, and a completely silent audio waveform for sound clips. Pay attention where it is directed the arrow when you stretch. If it is directed outside the clip, you regulate the clip duration. If it is on the opposite direction, you regulate the time gap between such clip and the next one in time. Very useful are the AV track options on the extreme left. You can use the lock button to lock and unlock the current track in order to block any possible modification on all of its clips inside until you unlock it. You can rename a track by clicking once on its name. Use the eye and the speaker icons to hide or mute the visual or the audio content within such track. Moreover, you can adjust the track volume as you like by using the first button right on top of the timeline. Use the stereo panner to balance stereo channels correctly. Use the yellow marker to set the whole track volume level, and the green marker to fix the volume level of the clip where the main red marker is placed. At the very bottom, move the yellow marker to adjust the volume level of the whole project. To insert a new track or remove one with all its clips, just right-click on one and use Insert New Track or Delete Track, respectively. Pinnacle Studio has several features to change the basic appearance of your visual clips. When selecting a clip from the timeline, the preview shows the project from the beginning of such clip in timeline mode. This has two useful icons in the bottom right corner next to Pip. Scale mode is used to scale the clip size by dragging the orange nodes on it. You can also click and drag the clip to move it or use the central node above to rotate it. Crop mode is used to crop the clip to remove parts of it you don't like by using the orange markers. To further edit the clip appearance, you can use the editor panel on the left. Check out our guide to know how to use it. With Pinnacle Studio, you can also apply advanced effects and transitions on your clips. Next to the library panel, all the yellow icons are dedicated to extras available, such as effects, transitions, text, and samples. Under effects, you find all the visual and audio effects available, which may differ depending on the Pinnacle version you have. Select an effect to check it through the preview in source mode on the right, and drag and drop it on a clip to apply it. You can apply multiple effects in this way. Clips with editing or effects applied always show a top pink line. Besides effects, you also have the transitions that add to special visual or audio effects at the beginning or the ending part of a clip. Visual transitions are applied on pictures and videos, affecting their transparency level in time. And audio transitions are added on sound files, acting on their volume level. You can apply visual and audio transitions by approaching the top clip corners and clicking and dragging through the internal side. The more the fade lasts, the slower the transition effect will be in time, as shown. From the transition section of the library panel, you have several kinds of transitions you can drag onto the default transition fades to change their effect in time. The new transition effect will be shown with its related icon. You can also apply a transition between two clips. Just put the two clips close enough and drag a transition in between. Watch our dedicated video to know more about effects and transitions inside Pinnacle Studio. With Pinnacle Studio, you can also add cool text and titles. Inside the library panel, under the title section, you have several ready text templates you can drag and drop on your timeline. Then, you can customize the text content and appearance by double-clicking on the text clip and using the title editor. Here, you can use the text settings to type in, adjusting style, size, and font, and look settings to set the text color, glow, and any shadow. You can also move, scale, and rotate text by clicking and dragging directly on the preview, using the nodes on it. Watch our dedicated video to check out more about text and titles. To save your project, just go to File, and then to Save Movie As. Pinnacle projects have an AXP file format that saves anything from the timeline content to all the settings on clip properties and effects. Whereas, if you want to obtain the final video to play back and upload, you have to switch to the Export Workspace. This workspace is divided in two. On the right, you have a final preview of your whole project content, and on the left, you can set several rendering settings, such as destination folder, video file name, and video file format. In particular, you can choose format or extension to fix the video settings as you prefer, or choose device or web to use a ready template suitable for devices, consoles, and social websites like YouTube. When all is set up, start rendering with Start Export. By default, the whole timeline is rendered from the beginning to the end of the last clip. If you want to render just a specific part of your timeline, just define it by placing the orange markers on the final preview before rendering. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our full guide dedicated to Pinnacle Studio to know more about this amazing and outstanding software.